Taxi cab right here. We believe that it was from a hijacking. We're unfor sure exactly where it happened at. We picked up the chase about 2 miles south of here at 16th and Coltrane. Right now we're fixing to cross that intersection. He's fixing to come through is going to be 50th and Coltrane, still northbound. Oklahoma City PD has been pursuing the individual. At this time it appears that they have stopped. You can see he's turning around right now. We're not exactly sure where or what he's doing. He went through the intersection at 23rd Street. Now he's westbound on 50th. I'll come around here and get on the other side. He went through the intersection at 23rd Street and struck a car. That's why there's damage to the front driver's side. He's going to come up on I-35 is going to be his next intersection. I'm not seeing any police at this time. As you can see, him just clearly passing cars. He sped up rapidly. The police kind of ended pursuit or really stopped in between 36th and 50th Street. But, all right, as you can see, the individual is running on foot. They dropped the car underneath the underpass. They're going to be in the far northeast part of the parking lot of Remington Park here. Just going through kind of a heavy wooded area. He's going to run up on a creek, I believe. There's on the Deep Fork River. There's actually people leaving. There's people leaving Remington Park now, but obviously they won't see it because they're fixing to be right there in some pretty tall grass and crossing the creek, as you can see here, Kent.
But right now, you don't see any officers in that near area at the moment.
Yeah, right now, we've got two or three police officers that are coming up on the vehicle, but they haven't, they're just now getting out on foot. So at this time, they're, looks like they're walking towards the creek.
This all started over on MLK when this person carjacked a cab, as you said, and kind of took a turn around northeast Oklahoma City on 50th, got on I-35. And we're not sure exactly what that individual's doing at the moment. He's throwing something.
They can't see each other at this time.
That looks like a cell phone in his hand, right?
That's he's on the south side.
That's what it appears to be, anyway, to me at least.
I don't. Yeah, let me.
John, can you give me an idea where the officers are at this time?
Yeah, well, it's kind of hard. Tell me exactly where he is so we can tell the cops. Hang on, Ken. I've got Steve at
Very
the desk.
Very good. I'll go ahead.
Right now, he's going to be, let me find the, I'm trying to find a police officer at this time, but there's a pretty heavy brush.
We can tell.
There's only one real big tree, as you can see, guys.
John is telling the officers right now where they need to be going. They're talking to our news desk, and they're using John as their locator, folks, for you folks at home. So our news desk is coordinating with the police department right now to try to help these officers find this individual that commandeered that vehicle earlier.
They'll keep coming either straight through the tree or around on the right side of the tree. They'll be right on top of them, guys.
It's hard to understand why this individual just doesn't give himself up. Surely he sees and hears our chopper. There we see those officers you're talking about. They're just a few feet away from him at this time. And again, it looked like he appeared to throw something away, possibly some drugs, a little bit earlier. And hopefully we can help the officers in finding that as well.
Yeah, there he's rolling around. Yeah, he's in custody now. It looked like for a second there he was trying to roll and run away, but kind of a good ending to this chase, guys. You know, like we said, or you said, Ken, it started, I believe you said, at MLK, went all the way a couple miles on the east side of town, went through an intersection there at 23rd and Coltrane, clipped a car.
Possibly with possession of drugs, if that's what it was. And there again, there's that wig. We were wondering exactly what role that play, why this person was wearing a wig. We don't know what happened before he carjacked this taxi, if that wig played a role in any other sort of a situation he might have been in, whether that was supposed to be some kind of a disguise that was being used for any other type of activity that could have happened before this chase happened. So there you see.